Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we took a keyed image and suppressed its colors and repaired the edges using the pixel spread node. All in all, things went pretty smoothly in all the keying examples. Now I am hoping that most of your experiences would be like that. However, there are a few gotchas worth pointing out, and most will stumble over them, including seasoned users. So please watch this video carefully. Let's start off with the first one. Resolutions. Resolutions and their bit depths can cause havoc for you and the modular keyer if they are not set up correctly. The general rule is to always ensure that all images used in the modular keyer, including background, have the same resolution. But what if they don't? Let's take a look at what happens. The key image is 1080 HD at 16-bit float, and the background is 720p HD at 8-bit. Now let's connect up the modular keyer node. You will see that when I connect the front and matte channels into the modular keyer node, the result view on the right shows a result. However, when I connect the different sized background, the result goes gray. The modular keyer is telling you that it cannot output a result because of resolution issues. So you have a couple choices. Firstly, you don't need the background connected to the modular keyer. You can simply break the connection and enter into the keyer. Remember that the background is optional. Alternatively, if you still want the background as a reference, you can leave the connection as they are and enter into the modular keyer. Here you will see the error persist in the keying tools. The way you fix this is to go to the modular keyer node bin and find the resize node. You can add this over the background image. Double-clicking on the resize node will bring up the menus, and you can set the resolution and bit depth to match the other sources. The master keyer in this case will stop complaining, and it will function correctly from this point. The next workflow gotcha is the auto key will always be on in the modular keyer, as it is a contained module from ConnectFX. So even if you turned auto key off in ConnectFX, make sure that you double check the setting here or you will keyframe unnecessarily. The next gotcha is viewing behavior. Looking at the master keyer as an example, it has multiple outputs as indicated in the node. So to view those outputs, you cycle the F4 keyboard shortcut to see those outputs. However, when you are looking at the second output of one node, and you go to another node with only one output, your viewer will go gray. This is because it does not have a second output view. Just press F4 again, and it will return the viewers. Speaking of viewers again, another gotcha is the context-sensitive nature of the cursor. You'll notice in these videos, the interface appeared to do what I want, and the views came up where I expected. This is because you place the cursor over the view you want before pressing a shortcut key. This means you don't land up with loads of views and getting that lost feeling in the interface. This also applies to working with ConnectFX in general and Action as well. That reminds me, if you do find yourself getting lost, just press the home icon to get back to the default layout and default interface. One last viewing gotcha, and this exists in the modular keyer overall result node. You'll sometimes notice that even though you have a background connected, you only see the key over a color, normally black. This is because when you double-click to enter into the result output node, you will see the mode is set to comp. The modular keyer switches to comp when you don't have a background loaded or the background is the wrong resolution. This ensures you can still pull keys and monitor the keying process uninterrupted. If you do have a background you want to view, just switch the viewing mode to result. And remember, if you are in Action and you want to see the Action context, just press 3. Another small behavior gotcha has to do with the masking tools in general, and it does affect the modular keyer as well. If you double-click on the GMask node, you will notice that the drawing buttons do not appear straight away. Why is that? Well, since smoke is quite contextually sensitive, including the viewers, you need to focus where you are going to draw the mask. You can't draw the masks in the schematic views, so it's best practice to hover over the viewer and press F4 to get the correct output from the masking node, and the drawing controls will appear. The good news is that you can draw on various views, so I like to draw on the front view with F1 as I can see the subject being rotoscoped and the performance is slightly increased for technical reasons. One last bonus tip to round off the series. If you have just created a keying pipeline that does the trick for your material and you want to keep it as a preset, you can save it in the customized node bin. Just break the footage and the result connections. Select the last node in the chain and change its name. Let's say Fave Key. Hold Shift and drag that node to the custom node bin, and all the nodes will follow. A new node has been created in the User Custom bin. This means whenever you use this user, these nodes will be available in every project. If the keying setup is project specific, you can save it into the Project Custom node bin for access in this project only. You can also load and save custom node bins to make them more portable and easier to backup. I hope that this series has given you good grounding to exploit the modular keyer to its fullest, and watch out for those modular keyer gotchas. Happy keying in smoke! Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.